So, we're all familiar with the PS1 classic Tomb Raiders, right? But what if I newly informed you or reminded you that more fully, officially developed classic Tomb Raiders exist? You might have heard of some of them. In fairness, they're the Tomb Raider Gold expansion packs. In North America, they're known as Tomb Raider 1 Gold, 2 Gold, and 3 Gold, but here in Europe, they're respectively known as Unfinished Business, Golden Mask, and Lost Artifact. They were developed by a side studio of Eidos's based in San Francisco by a small team using the same classic core design engine, and they were PC exclusive. On paper, you might assume they wouldn't measure up to the main games, but don't be so sure. They're actually damn good. They never really get mentioned or discussed in the community, but recently, Tomb of Ash livestreamed them with the actual developers, and it's clear they put a lot of heart into these expansions. So I wanted to spotlight them as well, because I've also really enjoyed them. And if you're into classic Tomb Raider, then it's a certainty that you will too. If you love a bit of Tomb Raider 1 and want some more of that adventure, then Unfinished Business is the perfect extra mile. It uses the same texture sets, the same non-linear level design ethos, the same sound effects, and so it really is through and through a true, and again, official expansion of Tomb Raider 1, even using an unmodified Tomb Raider 1 engine as well. Here, across 4 levels, you return to Egypt and survive a deadlier version of Atlantis. Tomb Raider 2 is your jam, and after completing it, you're left hungry for more of that specific Tomb Raider 2 flavor, then Golden Mask is the perfect dessert to that dish. Tomb Raider 2 Gold similarly uses an unmodified Tomb Raider 2 engine, retaining that 1997 feel. This time, you go to an Alaskan island to uncover a kingdom of gold over the course of 5 levels. Likewise, if Tomb Raider 3 is your cup of tea, then Lost Artifact is the perfect complementary to that serving. Just like the expansions before it, Tomb Raider 3 Gold uses the same mechanics, enemy types, and vehicles as their respective original titles. Picking up straight from Tomb Raider 3, you're in pursuit of a 5th meteorite artifact, taking you to France, Scotland, and beyond, featuring 6 levels. With these 3 games combined, they total up to 15 levels, which is the same length as Tomb Raider 1. So that's a lot of classic Tomb Raider content that's really gone under the radar. As I say, if you like early Tomb Raider, then you'll surely have a great time with these. Every level is long, large scale, and some of them are very experimental. Eidos San Francisco successfully achieved that while still sticking very close to Core Design's design mantra. These games basically have no real storyline presented in-game, but who really comes to Tomb Raider expecting a good storyline anyway? Let's be real, especially these days. As a bonus, there are 3 other officially and professionally produced levels I'm gonna mention that are also seemingly unknown or forgotten by the general public. The first is something called the Times Exclusive level. The Times is a British newspaper that had a deal for an entire level to be made for them for promotional purposes. It even features a full-on cinematic starring our favourite unholy mistress of darkness, Jonelle Elliot.
New tunnels. I see. I've stayed in bed for less.
This level, like all of them mentioned in this video, is for PC only. It's very short, easy, and utilizes only Last Revelation assets. The level is quite novel for the fact that Lara explores some of the areas you see in Last Revelation's flyby menu screen, so it's very cool to play in those previously out of reach areas. The second is the tutorial level for the level editor. I believe Eidos San Francisco put this together when writing the guide for the publicly released level editor, so you could follow along and recreate this level to learn the editor. So while it's a stretch to include it here, it is still technically an official level. It's been enhanced and made more easily accessible by Osvaldo on TRLE.net.
Level
Lastly, the third level is another stretch to call it official, but it's called Escape from Dragon's Lair, developed by an ex-Core Design member, which is why it's here. It's extremely difficult, uses the Tomb Raider 2 iteration of the level editor, and was released in 2019. I suspect it was made by Heather Stevens, formerly Heather Gibson, as she created the Dragon's Lair, and the page describes, "My level will continue right after Lara Croft killed the dragon. I was never satisfied with the level length of the Dragon's Lair." So, there you have it, a bit of Tomb Raider history partially illuminated. Some of these can be difficult to obtain, but in the description I'll provide details where I can, but there might be better sources out there. So let me ask, have you played any of the Gold games? Do you think they're better than the main releases? Let me know. My name is Seth, thank you so much for watching.